Welcome everyone to the Fall of Football vlog. Today,
we're gonna take you through today's game experience in downtown San Antonio between the UTSA Roadrunners and the Lamar Cardinal.
First stop on your game day experience is the famous Fiesta. Not just the Riverwalk is what people are all about here in San Antonio, but the shaded Fiesta on a hot day, to me, is just as nice. Enjoy the sights and sounds. We got all sorts of good food here, people. All sorts. Man, what is this?
Now, one thing here in San Antonio that people don't know, it's only about a 2-hour ride from Mexico. So when you get a gordita like this, it's about as authentic as it gets. All part of your game day experience here in San Antonio.
One detail about how I like to get into
towns when I first visit are General Scooters. The most popular brands are Bird and Lime.
Bird scooters can make getting around town a breeze
and are safe and easy and reliable to ride just with the smartphone. Biggest suggestion, download the apps beforehand and take advantage of taking a ride. You can get so much more done in a town that you don't know. And a special favorite of most is to use your AirPods and Google Maps to accompany on your route wherever you'll go. Just set it to bicycle mode and you can cover a town that most would take a day in a matter of hours.
And again, the more peaceful section of the Riverwalk that people just like to some live and some work on. We'll get to the world famous Riverwalks later. The one thing I do want to also talk about is the San Antonio's locals' favorite, the Esquire Tavern. This bar is actually 100 years old and has some of the best cocktails in San Antonio out here in the shade of the Riverwalk. Highly recommend it whether you're here for business or whether you're here for play, as tourists and locals alike love the Esquire Tavern and its cocktails. Speaking of cocktails,
drinking in San Antonio in the public is absolutely legal.
In fact, here is your spot. Here's your one of the numerous spots to catch the riverboat. Also behind the riverboat, I'd like to point out a bar that would be a must if you'd love to experience cocktails and yard margaritas like my man here. That would be the Thirsty Aztec.
Probably the most famous bar on the Riverwalk for people looking to have a little bit of an energetic time. Highly recommend the Thirsty Aztec right here at the beginning of what we call the circle of the Riverwalk. Another detail not to be missed as part of San Antonio's American-Mexican culture would be Justin's Ice Cream Company, Bonita Rita's, and most importantly, everyone's favorite since 1981, Justin's Ice Cream Company. The Riverwalk is known for not just its Mexican food, being able to drink wherever you go, has some of the best ice cream and Mexican treats around with a little bit of a Texas twist on it. So indulge your sweet tooth a little bit. You're in Texas. Now coming to San Antonio, coming to a game at the Alamo Dome to see UTSA or any other bowl game like the Alamo Bowl, and coming to the Riverwalk, you'd be a little remiss if you missed the Alamo, which the whole city is built around. We'll get to how the whole architecture above the river resembles that. But the Alamo is just a quick step, a few steps up from the main part of the Riverwalk, and about a half a mile from the dome itself.
There is a line process, so I would highly recommend reserving before you do come to the Alamo tour, and it won't take much of your time.
Now, one of my favorite bars in all of San Antonio happens to be right across the river. It's called the Beer Garden, and it's hidden in across from the Alamo, down the stairs on the Riverwalk, and in the higher Regency if you're drinking the Riverwalk side. Take a few videos and you'll soon see that. Very popular oasis on the Riverwalk is the River Center Mall. Built in 1988 and the biggest news in Texas at the time, it's become a nice attraction here in the Riverwalk, not just for shopping, but for good restaurants, bars, and drinks. And it's generally a place very near to the main Hyatt and Marriott hotels that all connects, and the Alamo Dome, and of course, the Convention Center. We'll take a look around the River Center, as it has been very well maintained, and you can still feel like you're on the river. The main spot for Roadrunner fans here in San Antonio, just a quick walk from the dome, is Yard House. Plenty of fans here, plenty of good beers. Great place to go before you head to the dome. Here is the best spot to park at the Alamo Dome, right here in Hemisphere Park. And you can enjoy a drink at the 106th floor restaurant, 750 feet above San Antonio and all the River Rock, right there at the Tower of the Americas. If you go online, you'll see all sorts of attractions. But here's the walk and the pedestrian rampway to the Alamo Dome. It is a pretty far walk, so if you can, scooter or even rideshare, I would recommend it. You're on vacation, right?
Rolls Royce looking at the stars. We got Dan right beside me.
When attending UTSA games at the Alamo Dome, most games will be half capacity, so all the great concessions here will probably not be open. However, the tailgating is very good, as you've seen in the last video. There's plenty of food trucks in the HEB Plaza to enjoy. One tip, the Alamo Dome was renovated in 2018. That renovation was only on the main concourse. So as you enter the building before you go up, you should probably buy your concessions here. And another tip, the Alamo Dome doesn't have escalators. It only has a handful of elevators too. So I would recommend eating and grabbing a drink before taking what are pretty robust stairs up to the third or second deck on the club level, which is where most seats are. So here inside the Alamo Dome, it's only $10 to get in. Only about 35,000 fans can fit in with the upper deck closed off. It's nice, it's air conditioned, concessions are reasonable. UTSA is a low-level WAC conference with a good product. Coming to see your team play, the best seats are probably over there in the club level. But here in the end zone, it's not too bad. Coming to UTSA game is at September 2021. You'll have a great option to get good seats, reasonably priced beverages. Alamo Dome has Papa John's, Nathan's, and a lot of local Texas treats like Mexican food and barbecue and yard margaritas. Truly a good value when considering the ticket price starts at $10.
Tragedy, and those that so bravely ran into the flames to save as many as they could, only to lose their lives as well. We now ask for all those in attendance today to observe 20 seconds of silence to commemorate the 20th anniversary of the 9/11 attack.
Trust the process. Let's get it.
Best food at the Alamo Dome, I always say, is the brisket. It's not bad. wraps up episode one of the UTSA experience versus Lamar in the fall of football. But highly recommend UTSA. You have your college band, your cheerleaders, your student section, your pomp, your circumstances. You even have a good tailgate scene right there in the parking lot. But for all the other reasons that makes this college football experience truly one of a kind and unique, I'd highly recommend. Whether you're looking for a cheap family destination or a great Saturday afternoon in San Antonio, seeing a game, drinking a few drinks, highly recommend and would encourage you to get the great value of UT San Antonio. Like and subscribe.